Well, Professor Nabil Mikhail now joins us from studios in Washington. He's with the George Washington University. Many thanks for joining us here on Press TV, Professor Mikhail. Now, these terrorist attacks are becoming almost routine for the people of Syria, who are continuing to pay the price for this proxy war set up by the West. Why do you think we are not seeing much of a reaction coming from the international community in condemning these terrorist attacks, where, of course, the civilians are the ones being killed?
The world is still watching the tragedies as they unfold in the Syrian theater. Of course, what happened today is something very sad and tragic. But the West is not showing too much emotion for Syria. But what happened today should be an important message, not just about the evolution of the conflict in Syria, but about the method of warfare. We're witnessing a new era in the Syrian fighting that could be labeled urban terrorism, which means the selection of high-value targets. The wars you mentioned, near the central bank, a bomb car in downtown Damascus. These all are indications that the war in Syria over the question of democracy and regime change have become urban terrorism methods. They can promote the goals of its perpetrators, but also they could very well backfire.
Well, so I guess the question over here is that if the government of President Bashar al-Assad does fall, how will the West even interact with a government which is rooted so deeply in this urban terrorism, as you've called it?
In this case, you will have really serious deliberations over the future of Syria by the big powers. I think Russia is becoming more of an important player because by withholding his role in Syria actively, Barack Obama has allowed other players to step in. Among them is Vladimir Putin and the Russian bureaucratic and military and political interests. But the question is that urban terrorism is a double-edged sword. It could, as I said, backfire. It could project a bad image of those who execute it. And also, it could tempt it, the rival, in this case, the government of Bashar al-Assad, to penetrate and infiltrate these cells because they operate on a landscape that could be monitored, that could be tracked down. So before the fall of Assad, let us just contemplate and scrutinize some terrible scenarios, urban terror, attack and counterattack. It could mean also maximum targets, maximum attack, and maximum counterattack. So the violence in Syria is entering into another round of tragic events, more lethal. And I'm quite sure that there could be a temptation to initiate an assassination campaign. If a person is captured, he could also reveal a lot of information. So we're not really into the Assad being removed from the picture at this moment. We are witnessing a very sophisticated, very dangerous, very lethal stage in the Syrian civil war. And it could really backfire on who does it.
And do you think that the U.S. and its allies within the region have taken these risks into account? Let me repeat that question. Do you think the West and
its question again, please?
Yes. Do you think the West and its allies have taken these risks into account as they continue to support these insurgents?
To some extent, the military, especially the military establishments, are doing cost-benefit analysis of supporting the rebels in Syria. But the question is that you cannot really, there is no conclusive end. There is no decisive battle that could finish the conflict. It could be the battle over Damascus that could decide the future of Syria. For how long will it go? Will some countries change their positions? Things are still unknown. The story you told me and I'm commenting out is an indication that we're moving into more dangerous, more troublesome phases of the Syrian civil war. The people in Syria have to do things, either to escape or to adapt normally to these scenes of violence.
Okay, we're going to have to leave it there. I'm afraid we have run out of time. Professor Nabil Mikhail with George Washington University joining us from studios in Washington. Professor, it's always a pleasure having you with us on Press C.